Part of that mission, our programs illuminate Jewish culture and storytelling, historic and current anti-Semitism, resistance against injustice, and more. We hope you will spend time here at the museum and visit our exhibitions, The Holocaust, What Hate Can Do, Survivors, Faces of Life After the Holocaust, photographs by Martin Scholler, and The Garden of Stones by Andy Goldsworthy. Also, keep an eye out for this fall's exhibition opening of Courage to Act, Rescue in Denmark, our first exhibition for visitors 9 and up about the incredible story of the Danish rescue. Learn more about the museum, our exhibitions, and our work at mjhnyc.org. Your participation, donations, and membership make the museum what it is. We are grateful to our members who enjoy exclusive programs, exhibition previews, and free admission. Learn more, make a donation, and join at mjhnyc.org/join. You can also find information about our upcoming public programs on our website. Before I pass the microphone, I'd like to ask everyone to silence their cell phones or anything else that might make noise during the concert. Thank you so much. And now I am pleased to introduce Esther Muller, who helped organize today's concert. I'd also like to thank Maxine Dover for all of her efforts too. Esther was born in Israel and is the child of Holocaust survivors. She devotes her time to connecting the Jewish community to Israel. We're very grateful to have her help in organizing this and due to here with us today. I'm very pleased to introduce Esther Muller.
I can't believe you're here. Oh my God, and it's Father's Day. So first of all, thank you to all the fathers that are here. Thank you for all the fathers that are gonna be fathers. Thank you for all the dads that are fathers. And to our Zoom audience, hello and welcome. And we're really excited because not only are we celebrating an amazing birthday, which is Israel's 75th birthday, but we're also celebrating Father's Day at the same time. And in our Jewish tradition, we always say besimchot only, which means if we can get together during happy times, that's what we want. So I want to take a couple of seconds to just tell you that my father, 75 years ago, was in the Haganah. And Haganah is what helped make Israel the land that she became. So it's only 75 years ago when my dad was in the army for 2 years and created the state of Israel. So as a legacy to him, it's Father's Day. I want to wish my dad, who just passed away 2 years ago, a happy Father's Day. And to all the fathers that are fighting the wars in Israel and their children and everyone else, I wish you all good health and good future. And what's beautiful is that we're celebrating 75 years, but I want to tell you about the future of Israel. The future of Israel looks great. And I would appreciate everyone remembering that politics is not as important as the state, the Jewish state that we have. And to always remember what it took in order for us to be here today. And I want to introduce you to an amazing, amazing person. He's an angel that we've been working with. He happens to be also the grandson of Holocaust survivors. He also happens to be the founder of an organization called Or Movement. Or means light. And we bring lights, and he brings lights to the Negev and the Galil. And for the last 20 years, he's been able to create 8 new communities in the Negev and the Galil, and there are 49,000 new pioneers that are living in the Galil. There are 64 communities and 107 political community buildings that have been built. So in order to keep Israel strong, we believe the Negev and the Galil is an important part of Israel. It's almost 70% of Israel. And I'm so lucky and so happy to let you know he's also the son of Dudu Fisher, and he's going to be here for the next few seconds. So please give him a big hand to Ophir Fisher, our future generation.
Thank you very much, Esther. And do you hear me? So I don't think that there is a better place to speak about our journey than here, because it all started when we went to visit the Holocaust camps in Poland. It's me and another three friends, childhood friends, that decided to join the school trip. We went to Poland and we stood there in Treblinka watching the 17,000 stones that represents 17,000 communities. And something at that point changed in our mind, something changed in our life. We suddenly need to dedicate our life for the state of Israel, and we need to do everything that is in our powers to make Israel the best country in the world to live in and the safest place for Jewish people from all over the planet. We didn't know, we were 17 years old, we were in high school, we didn't know what exactly we were going to do. We just knew that one day we will start an organization, we will call it OR. I heard that Esther explained that OR means light. We believe in fighting, not fighting the darkness, but just add light. That's why we called it OR. And we said we will establish an organization one day and we will do some good things for Israel. We joined the army, and through this entire time, we tried to understand what is the thing, what is the one thing that we should touch? What is the one thing that can become the Zionist mission of our generation? You know, our grandparents, my grandfather came from the Holocaust at the age of 18, yashar straight to the Palmach, fighting to release Jerusalem. Our parents made Israel grow, and what is our role? We asked ourselves, what is our role in Israel's future? And we kept asking this question while we served. I served 6 years in the Navy as a captain in the Marines. My friends served in other places. And through this time, we kept asking ourselves this question. And when we got out of the army, we decided, instead of taking the trip like any other Israeli in South America or India or Thailand, you know, sorry, like the trip after the army, we decided. Hot. I don't know what's going on. I hope it will not happen to Dudu later. So we traveled around the country and we were looking for this thing. We asked people, what do you think is the most important thing to do in Israel? And very fast, we found the Negev and the Galil, the south part of Israel and the north part of Israel. It's not that we didn't know about their existence, but suddenly we understood that these areas, the Negev and the Galil, are a key component for a healthy growth for the state of Israel. Israel is 75% of the territory of Israel is the Negev and the Galil. Yet less than 25% of the people actually live there. Now, it might not have mattered in any other country, but Israel is the fastest growing country in the West world. I'm not sure if you know these details, but Israel has 3.1 kids per family. It's a very fast growth relative to any other Western country that usually they are shrinking and not growing below 2.1 kids. And Israel is growing, and we are 9.7 million people today. And in 2.5 decades, in 2048, which will be Israel's centennial birthday, we are going to be close to 20 million people in the country. And yeah, it's amazing thing to, if you think about it, it's a really amazing phenomena. But unfortunately, if we're not gonna get ready for it, this massive growth can be also a problem. Look at what happens today in Israel, where the focus, 75% of the people live in the triangle between Jerusalem, Tel Aviv, and Haifa. Majority of the country lives there. and see what happens in the lack of housing opportunities that the young generation have, in the cost of living, in lack of infrastructure, traffic jams, transportation issues, open spaces. So imagine that 6.5 million people that today live in the center out of the 9.7 million people are going to double itself to 13 million people while the development of the infrastructure is not enough. So this will cause many, many problems which we don't have the space or time now to get into, but we're happy to share more information later on. But the Negev and the Galil, however, which can have hundreds of thousands of housing units, development all from scratch, innovation centers, you can be creative. It's not so crowded as it is now in the center of the country. It's an open window of opportunity for the young generation and for everybody else. Beyond the practicality of the Negev and the Galil to actually provide solutions to the young generation that today can't find themselves in Israel, in most cases, the layer above it is something that I think that you in the US suffer from that. We are suffering it in Israel, and it's the unity. It's the segregation, it's the division between communities. Israel needs something big, and I think that every country needs, not only Israel. But since the days of Israel, since the days of Herzl, nobody came and said, I have a dream. This is the vision of Israel. This is where we are heading. We are keeping putting out fires instead of saying, all right, this is where we're going and this is how we're gonna get there. And we believe that Israel needs this vision, something that can really bring together all of us. It doesn't matter if you're from the right wing or from the left wing, if you're religious, if you're secular, if you're Jewish or not Jewish, but live in Israel. We need a uniting vision, and that's what we believe is the, I would say, the most important role of the Negev and the Galil for us these days, and this is how we see it. So after all these understandings, the needs, the practical needs, and also the unity needs of the Negev and the Galil, we decided to adopt this mission. And we moved to the Negev with the help of Arik Sharon, a good friend of my father, introduced us to Arik Sharon, and we met him, and he said, guys, I was waiting for someone like you for 15 years. Let's do it together. And together with him, we started our first town in the Negev in 1999, April 21st, 1999. And we moved to the Negev from Petah Tikva, and we started growing this community. And later on, we started the organization, and we called it Or Movement. And Esther mentioned everything that we did, establishing new towns and relocating almost 50,000 people to the Negev and the Galil. And as I said before, the idea is divided between the vision and also the practicality. This is how we also act as an organization. We are pushing policy change, working with the government, changing priorities, directing funding, huge funds for the Negev and the Galil from the government. And on the other hand, working bottom up in the field, creating communities, helping establish innovation center, working with the municipalities, and so on and so forth. And I'm inviting you all to go to our website, it's Or Movement, you can find it easily. Maybe whoever is in charge on the Zoom can send the link in the chat. And you're welcome to stick around later. Esther is on our board and we'll be very happy to provide information once this show is over, or find us online. And thank you very much for being here and for listening. And hope to see you all another time. Thank you so much. Last thing before I go, I'm actually on my way to Israel, so I'm not gonna stay to the end of the show. This is why I referred you to Esther. Usually, if my father invites me to speak in his show, so he starts the show and then he introduces me. Today, I think it's the first time in my life that it's opposite. So, and it fits the day, you know, the Father's Day. And I'm really, really privileged to be here and to call the one and only Jean Valjean in Broadway and West End. The other things that you know about him. And I'm privileged to call Dudu Fischer my father. Thank you.
מלאה אשר מלאה בטרם קור יציר נברא לנסה בחפצו קור ואחרי ככלות הכל לבדו עם לוח נוער והוא היה והוא הווה והוא הווה והוא יהיה בתפארה אדון עולם אשר מלך בטרם כל יציר נמלא נסה וחפצה כל הזי מלך שבו ניקה אחרי ככלות הכל לבדו עם לוח נורא הוא היה והוא עובד והוא יהיה בתפארה אדון עולם אשר מלך בטרם כל יציר נמלא נסה וחפצה כל הזי מלך שבו ניקה אחרי ככלות הכל לבדו עם לוח נורא והוא היה והוא עובד בתפארה והוא עובד והוא יהיה בתפארה סינג ודי אדון בטרם קור לעת נעשה בחפצו קור אזי מלך אזי מלך שמו נקרא Israel. He saw me singing in a wedding or something. And he came and he said to me, "Where are you a cantor?" I said, "I'm not." He said, what are you going to do?" I said, "Well, I took dentistry. I'm going to study to be a dentist." He looked at me and said, "Are you crazy? With your voice you're going to smell stinking mouths of other people for the rest of your life." He said, "I'm the president of a synagogue in Winnipeg, Canada, and I'd like you to come to daven for us Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur." I said, "Nah, I'm not good at that. I'm going to do dentistry. This is my mission in life. I love being it. I want to be a dentist." He said to me, "Look, I'm a president. I'm going to give you $5,000 and a ticket." I said, "I'm coming." It changed my life. So in my new show that I'm working now on, I'm going to go on a world tour, 50th anniversary of me on stage, telling all the stories about my life. And I was thinking, what can I say to the people who are going to come to the show? What can I say to you people? What can I say to the people on Zoom? What kind of a song can I sing for you? And I was thinking, there's only one song that comes to my mind whenever I can really say to you. Tell the story of how great a love can be, the sweet love story that is older than the sea, the simple truth about the love you bring to me. Where do I start? With your first hello, you gave a meaning to this empty world of mine. There's never been another love, another time. You came into my life and made the living fine. You feel my heart. Special things, with angel songs, with wild imaginings. You fill my soul with so much love that anywhere I go, I'm never lonely. With you alone, who could be lonely? I reached for your hand. It's always there. How long does it last? Can love be measured by the hours in a day? I have no answers now, but this much I can say. I know I'll need you till the stars all burn away. And you be there. How long does it last? Can love be measured by the hours in a day? I have no answers now, but this much I can say. I know I'll need you till the stars all burn away.
Thank you so much. First of all, I'd like to thank really the museum, and I'd like to thank Ben and Esther. Ben and Esther, they're celebrating today their anniversary. Where's Esther? What are you doing there? Esther is responsible for this show, by the way, responsible for bringing me here. So Ben, thank you very much. I love you so much, really, because I know that Esther was supposed to be with you, but now she's with me. Sorry about it, but she needs to work for Israel. You know, I was very fortunate to be one of the very, very fortunate kids in my school to have two grandparents and two grandmothers. Two grandfathers and two grandmothers. One of my grandfathers came to Israel before the war because he was a Zionist. He left in Lithuania all his family, and they were all murdered by Lithuanians, by the way, not the Nazis. And my other grandfather was saved by a Polish family. Ukraine, Polish. Sometimes it was Poland, sometimes it was Ukraine, you know what I mean? in a bunker which was dug underneath this family, Kvarchak family, in the Ukraine. They hid 16 members of my father's family. And this Zaidi, who came to Israel, was one of the best things that happened to me in my life, because he was the one to teach me everything I know about music, especially about Jewish music. And I'd like to sing for you this song about this man that I love. My Zaidi lived with us in my parents' home. He used to laugh, he put me on his knee, and he spoke about his life in Poland. He spoke but with a bitter memory, and he spoke about the soldiers who would beat him. They laughed at him, they tore his long black coat, and he spoke about the synagogue that they burnt down, and the crying that was heard beneath the smoke. But Zaidi made us sing, and Zaidi made us laugh, and Zaidi made us Kiddush Friday night. And Zaidi, oh my Zaidi, how I loved him so. And Zaidi used to teach me right from wrong. His eyes lit up when he would teach me Torah. He taught me every line so carefully, and he spoke about our slavery in Egypt, and how God took us out to make us free. But winter went by, summer came along, I went to camp to run and play. And when I came back home, they told me, Zaidi's gone. And all his books were packed and stored away. And how it came to be, it took us slowly over many years. We just stopped being Jewish like my Zaidi was, and no one cared enough to shed a tear. Sing, and Zaidi made us laugh, and Zaidi made us say the Pesach night. And Zaidi, oh my Zaidi, how I loved him so. And Zaidi used to teach me wrong from right. And the winters went by, many summers came along, and now my children sit in front of me. And who will be the Zaidi of my children? Who will be the Zaidi if not me? Who will be the Zaidis of our children? Be the Zaidis, if not we. us sing. And Zadie made us laugh. And Zadie made us Kiddish Friday night. And Zadie, oh my Zadie, how I loved him so. And Zadie used to teach me right from wrong. And Zadie, oh my Zadie, how I love you so. And Zadie used to teach me right from wrong. Thank you. I can't tell you how happy I was that Ophir, my son, was here to introduce me. I don't think it ever happened. Did he tell you that it never happened before? It's Father's Day for me. This is the best thing that could happen to me, that he's here. He's to leave. He's going back to Israel on a flight tonight. Anyway, you know, I was living... What is it? Nesiatova. That's right. Amen. Bon voyage, what we say in Yiddish. Fog is in the height, that's right. I was born in Petah Tikva. You heard about this place? Petah Tikva is a big city today in Israel. But then in 1961, my parents decided to leave and live in the north of Israel. The only problem was that there in Petah Tikva, I studied in a religious school. And in Tivon, where they moved to, there was no religious school. I was the only religious kid in the class. I remember we weren't used to wear yarmulkes then. Then we used to have berets. We had big berets, you know. That's how we used to walk. And the moment I walked into the school, my beret became a spaceship. One kid to the other, one kid to the other. And I was crying. I really felt very bad about it, and I was crying. I was very lucky that my teacher was you will not know the name, Ben Arzi, Shmuel Ben Arzi, who is actually Sarah Netanyahu's father. Yeah, and he was a great guy. He was a great man. And I remember in the breaks, he used to call me out and say, "Dudu, don't worry. Everything is going to be okay. You're going to be very well here. You will be received very well. Don't worry about it. Don't cry. Don't have to cry, because what time is going to do, nothing can heal better than time." And really, it was like this. And I became very, very, in a very short time, I became very friendly with all the kids. But the problem was that the kids used to meet once a week. And when was it? Friday night. Friday night, all the kids used to get together, dancing, and, you know. But me, I was going with my father, coming back from the synagogue Friday night. My father used to walk very slowly like this, you know, like after the chulnt. And I used to tell him, "Dad, come on, let's do it quicker, because I have to go. I have to go to the class, to the evening of the class, of my class." So quickly, 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 we ate, and then I went. And that was the first place that I heard this wonderful music that I never heard before in my life. And since then, since this first night there in Tivon, in the class, Friday night, that's the music they used to play. You are my destiny. You are what you are to me. You are my happiness. Heaven, and heaven alone can take your love from me. Never, never be. be. Come on, open your mouth and sing with me. You. Oh, thank God. You are what you are to me. You are my happiness. That's what you are. Only you can make this world seem right. Only you can make the darkness bright. Only you and you alone can thrill me like you do and fill my heart with love for only you. I'm so young and you so old, this my darling I've been told. I don't care just what they say, 'cause forever I will stay. You and I will be as free as the birds upon a tree. Oh, please stand by me. Oh, put your hand. Hold me in your arms, baby. Squeeze me oh so tight. Show me that you love me too. So I was working very nicely through the, you know, the time, and then an uncle of mine who came from South Africa came to visit us, came to visit my parents, and he was driving his Oldsmobile 65. Remember these cars? Like a big car on the road in Tivon where I was living. It was a little shtetl, you know, and nobody saw a car like this before. And then he saw me walking on the pavement without my beret. And he came to my parents and he gave them a mishabeirach. What are you doing to the kid? The kid is gonna be to grow up nothing. You have to send him to learn in a yeshiva to start. I said, what yeshiva? I don't want to be in the yeshiva. I'm happy here. It's my guys here. I'm very happy. No, 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 you have to go to yeshiva. I said, I'm not going, I'm not going. He came to me and said, he was a very rich guy, by the way. And he said to me, what can I buy you so you go to learn in a yeshiva? I was thinking, well, now he's talking. Now he's talking. But me, you know, I was foolish, I was stupid, I was a little kid. Instead of saying, I'd like to have an apartment, one of your apartments in Tel Aviv, I said, guitar, if you get me a guitar, I'll go to the... The next morning, I had my guitar at my door, and I went to the yeshiva. Now, in the yeshiva, I was a very, very Elvis Presley guy, really, all my life, since I learned this music. And in the yeshiva, you're not allowed to sing Elvis Presley. Never mind singing Elvis Presley. Listening to Elvis Presley was not allowed. But I used to have one of these... inventions of the 60s, the biggest invention of the 60s is the transistor. Sometimes I used to sneak out from classes, Talmud classes, Bible lessons, math classes, sit on the floor, on the stairs, watch that nobody sees me from the rabbis, and sing to myself my Elvis. Wise men say only fools rush in.
but I can tell love with Pishupan. The rabbi. How did he get here? No, Dudele. What is it? What is it that you hear? What you're listening in your ear? What is it? What do you listen? I said, this is a very big cantor. He said, cantor, what's his name? I said, his name is Elvisiao Preslotsky. Preslotsky, he said, I never heard Preslotsky. I heard Kosovitsky, I heard Hirschman, I heard Fautin, I heard everybody. I never heard Preslotsky. What does he sing, this guy? I said, what does he sing? He sings love songs between the people of Israel and the Rabbeinu Shel Olam. That's what he does. Wow, really? Sing to me something that he sings. Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't tell? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can tell falling in love with you, for I can't help falling in love. Now I said to the rabbi, now comes the cantorial part. Love, love. I think he was the only rabbi in the world to love Elvis Presley. Because every record that used to come out of the market, I used to buy for him. And he loved Elvis Presley. One day I'm walking in the corridor of the yeshiva. He comes in and he says to me, Dudu, I have an idea. I want to talk to you about it. Come to my office. I went to his office. I said, what's the idea? He says, well, I don't know if it's possible, but you tell me if it's possible. I said, I'll tell you, Rabbi, for you, everything is possible. For you, I'll do anything. He says, you know, Purim is coming now. He says, in 2 weeks we have Purim. How about if we do the service on Friday night a la Preslotsky? I said, you mean to say you want me to say? He says, yes, is it possible? I said, for you, Rabbi, anything. And with all the rabbis sitting there in front of the ark, I began to sing.
A one, a two, a one, two, three. Shamo v'zacho bedibur echad, ishmiyanu kela meyuchad. Hashem echad u'shimo echad, l'shem multifere v'litila, let's rock. Let's rock. Everybody in the whole same block. We're dancing to the J-House rock. Boy, ve-shalom, ateret ba'ala. Gam ve-simcha, ove-tzohola. Toch emune, yam-zgula. Boy, chala, boy, chala. Let's rock. the whole say block was dancing to the J-House rock, dancing to the J-House rock. Shabbat the bap the bap the bap the bap. Ve'imru amen.
On the piano, my friends, the maestro, the one and only Shai Bachar. So I finished the army and I started singing. V'ahin soll ich gehen? Wer kennt für mich? V'ahin soll ich gehen? Als verschlossen jede Tür, sieht die Welt groß genug. No for me is eng und klein. Wie ein Blick muss zurück, was zerstört jeder Blick. Dort dahin will ich gehen. Ei, 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 Bess. Mein, oh. Meine Heimale dort, wie ich hob, meine Kinder schön verbracht. Bist du gewesen am Ulin Best? Meine Heimale dort, wie ich hob, meine Kinder schön verbracht. Jeden Schabes pfleg ich laufen mit alle Jüngerlach gleich, sitzen unter die grünen Bäume, Malach, warfen Stein der Lach in Tag. Ei, 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 Bez, mein meine Heimale dort, wie ich hob, meine Kindersche Jorn verbracht. In dem Beis Amigdosh, in a Winkelheide, sitzt die Almune Bastion allein. Hier bin ich in Liedere, wie dicke Seide, und singt ihm zum Schlafen a Liedeleche. Ai, lilu, lilu, lilu. Und er riedel es wie Gehle, steht a chlorweißen Ziegele, das Ziegele ist gefroren handeln, das wird sein dein Beruf. Oh, schinke es mit Mandeln, schlafe je idale, schlafe. Bei mir bist du schön, bei mir hast du Geld, bei mir bist du Teil wie der Welt. Bei mir bist du schön, bei mir hast du Geld, bei mir bist du Teil wie der Welt. La 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 la. One more time, la 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 la. Schein wie die Lewune, lächtig wie der Stern, von Himmel am Matune, bist du mir zugeschickt, mein Glück hab ich gewinnen, wenn ich hab dich gewinnen, scheint wie tausend Sinnen, hast mein Herz war Glück. Deine Zähne lach, weiße Bärlach, mit deinen schönen Augen, deine Haare lach, weiße Bärlach, hast dich zugezeugen, schein wie die Lewune, lächtig wie der Stern,
funi mella matone bistu mitsugishi. Ich will bei euch a kasche fragen, sag mir wer es kennt. Mit welche Teiere vermeigens wünscht Gott allem Menn. Mein Käuf es nicht war keine Geld, das gibt mir noch um Sist. Und doch als Menn verliert man, wie viel Tränen man vergisst. A zweite gibt nem keinem nicht, ha er dein Gewehr. Sot verloren, der weiß schon was ich mein. Heidische, nicht doch ein besser auf der Welt, mein jüdische Mann. Oi, wei, wie bitter, wenn sie fährt. Wie schön und lichtig ist in Haus, wenn die Mama ist dort. Wie treurig finster wird, wenn Gott nimmt ihr auf Eul am Abort. In Wasser, in Feier, wollt sie geläufen vor ihr Kind. Nicht halt mir teuer, das ist gewiss die größte Sünd. Oh, wie glücklich und reich ist der Mensch, was hat als eine schöne Matune geschenkt von Gott. Nur ein altitschke jüdische Mame. For those of you who don't understand Yiddish, I miss her more than ever now. My Yiddish mama, I long to kiss her wrinkled brow. I long to hold her hand once more, as in days gone by, and ask her please forgive me for things I did and made you cry. How few were her pleasures, she never cared for fashion style. Her jewels and her treasures, she found them in her baby's smile. Oh, I know that I owe what I am today to this wonderful lady, so old and gray, to this wonderful Yiddishe mame. Mama, 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 mama. Mama. Mama, 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 mama. Mame, 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 mame.
Shai Bachar. Every time I speak about my parents, about my grandparents, I remember one thing. Dear God, you've made many, many poor people in the world, eh? I know it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I would have just a little fortune, eh? If I were a rich man, yabby dibby 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 dum, all day long I'll be diddle dum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yabby dibby 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 dum, all day long I'll be diddle dum. If I were a little bit rich, I'd build a big tall house with rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with the real wooden floors below. There will be one long staircase just going up and one even longer coming down. And one more leading nowhere just for show. Everybody goes oy vey. Come on. This is good for a little audience. But for a big audience, I want to hear oy vey. Come on.
Oy vey.
Oh! I'd fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And all them will bang like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. Is this the little girl I carry? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be so tall? And wasn't it yesterday when they were small? Sunrise, sunrise, swiftly fly the days. Seedlings stand overnight to sunflowers blossoming, given as we gaze. One more time. Sunrise, sunrise, swiftly fly the years. One season following another, laden with happiness and tears. To life, to life, l'chaim, 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 to life. One day it's honey and raisin cake, next day is stomach cake. Drink l'chaim, to life, l'chaim. Wait, one second. You know, in Hebrew, when you write the word mayim, you write it with one yud. Because mayim, water, we can drink alone. But yayin, we write with two yuds. That means a yayin, you need a partner. When I say lechaim, please repeat me. Lechaim. Oh, to life, lechaim. Lechaim, lechaim, to life. If you've been lucky, then Monday was no worse than Sunday was. Drink lechaim, to life. Hey, God would like us to be joyful, even though our hearts lie panting on the floor. How much more can we be joyful, even when there's nothing to be joyful for? Now I want a big lechaim. To life, lechaim! Lechaim, lechaim, to life. It gives you something to think about, something to drink about. Drink l'chaim, to life.
Thank you very much. So, I started to sing cantorial music, and then in 1986, I went to London, and I went to see a musical which changed my life. It was called Les Miserables. I went back to Israel from London. I was sitting with my manager, and I said to him, listen, this musical overwhelmed me, and I have to do this part of Jean Valjean in Les Miserables. He said, what do you mean you want to do Les Miserables, Jean Valjean? You've never been on stage, you never acted on stage, you're a cantor, you're a chazan, you're a Yiddish songwriter. I said, that's what I want to do. I don't want to go nowhere. I don't want to do any more concerts for Yiddish and cantorial music. All I want to do is Jean Valjean. And he got me an audition. I auditioned. And I left. I left Israel to go to Kutcher's Country Club. The Catskill Mountains, Alav HaShulem. I was standing there rehearsing the prayer of Kol Nidre with my big choir when the phone rang. Kent Fisher telephone. I ran backstage, picked up the phone. It was my manager from Israel. He said to me, Dudu, are you sitting down? Because I have some news for you. I said, what is it? He said, you got the part. You got the part of Jean Valjean. There was nothing in the world I wanted to do more than this. By the way, did you see, any one of you, if you saw Rough Diamonds? Yeah. Saw Rough Diamonds? I know you can't recognize me there, but it was great fun, and some more stuff is coming now. So I went back to the rehearsal with the choir. I was singing Kol Nidre Vesarei, but in my mind, all I heard was, I was so excited about the fact that I got the part. All the music of Les Miserables was playing in my heart, in my mind, when I was singing with the choir. And if I could take you then and just put you in my mind, that's what you would hear. Oh,
Yom Kippur Yivzeh Ad Yom Kippur my fellow men, how can I ever face myself again? My soul belongs to God, I know I made that bargain long ago. He gave me hope when hope was gone. He gave me strength to journey on. Who am I? Who am I?
Thank you. So, Cameron McIntosh, whom you all know who he is, right? I mean, the biggest producer here on Broadway. Esther, you will become one day Cameron McIntosh, I think. You have the skills. He came to Israel for the premiere, and right after the premiere, he came to me and he says, "Dudu, I'd like you to come to Broadway." And I said, "Me, Dudu Fischer from Petach Tikva?" He said, "Yes, I'd like you to come on Broadway." I said, "I'd love to. This is a dream of every singer, every actor, every dancer to be on Broadway. This is a dream. But I don't think it's going to happen." He said to me, "Why not?" I said, "Well, I can't work Friday nights and Saturday matinees." He said, "Why not?" I said, it's an old story. He said, "Let me think about it. I have to go back to New York. Let me think about it." And before he leaves the room, I said, Cameron, there's one more little thing. Just one more little thing that I have to tell you. Well, I can't sing all song. Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Sukkot, Pesach, Shavuos, Tisha B'Av, Erev Tisha B'Av, Chanukah, Purim." He said, "You must be joking." I said, "No, I'm not. He said, "All right, let me see what I can do." So he left, and it took some time, and time, and time, and I never heard back from him. And my mother said to me, "Go see the Lubavitcher Rebbe. Get a brocha from the Lubavitcher." I said, "Mom, are you crazy? When am I going to get a brocha from the Lubavitcher Rebbe to do Broadway? I mean, what's that? She says, "Yes, go talk to the Lubavitcher Rebbe." At that time, you couldn't see him anymore, one-on-one. The only way to see the Lubavitcher Rebbe was if you were a godfather for a Russian baby who came out from Russia uncircumcised, and you were his godfather. I said, "I'm going to do it. Whatever the cost is, doesn't matter." So here I am, Brooklyn, sitting in a dark room, waiting for the baby to come in. And the door opens, and a big zhlob comes in, like 7 foot. And I'm looking for the pram. I said, "Where's the baby? Excuse me, sir, where's the baby?" the baby. He said, baby? He says, me baby. I said to the rabbis, listen, nobody told me that the baby is going to be 40 years old. And there's no way I'm going to hold him on my lap while you're cutting what you do. No way, because I can faint. He said to me, don't worry. We're going to put a curtain between you and the mice, and you're not going to see anything. I said, all right. So they put a curtain. They did what they did, and both of us went to see the rabbi. And the rabbi gave him a blessing, and then he turns to me. And I look in his eyes, and I don't know how to start to talk. What am I going to say to him? So the first thing I said, Rebbe, do you know Les Miserables? That's what came to my mind. He said to me, if I know, I forgot that this rabbi had 9 doctorates from the Sorbonne in Paris, okay? 9 doctorates, yes, from there. He says to me, of course, he said, I know. He said to me, now, this is something that I learned from the rabbi. He said, do you know how long it took Victor Hugo to write Les Miserables? Any one of you know how long Victor Hugo wrote Les Miserables? How long? 28 years. You're right. 28 years. Very good. And this is something that I learned from the Rebbe, the Lubavitcher Rebbe. Now I felt free and I said to him, Rebbe, there's a musical about Les Mis and they want me to be on Broadway, but I told them that I can't play Friday nights and Saturday matinees and I can't do this. I need a broch, Rabbi. He held my hand. And he looked through me, right through me. When he looked at you, you felt like somebody is looking through you. And he said to me, in Yiddish now, he said, Halt sich stark mit Yiddishkeit, en alts wird sein gut. He said, don't worry about your Yiddishkeit. Don't be ashamed to say that you're Jewish and you don't work Friday night and Saturday and Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur. You're at home. You have to be at home. You have to go to synagogue to daven on these days. And I left. And a week later, I received a call from Cameron McIntosh telling me, come on over, the role is yours. So here I am, backstage on Broadway. I'm walking to rehearse, starting rehearsals. And I'm walking to my door, to my dressing room door. And I'm very nervous. I don't know how everybody's going to accept me. I'm different. I'm doing only 6 shows a week, everybody else does 8 shows a week. I'm not eating everything they eat. I'm not drinking everything they drink. I'm different. And I'm walking up and I see the door of my dressing room and it says in golden letters, Dudu. No, they said, no way we're going to put Dudu on Broadway. It's David, right, David? I said, all right, write whatever you want, write David, write Dudu. But David Fisher, Jean Valjean. And then I go nearer, and underneath my name, I saw, in smaller letters, I saw J.C. Sheets, Shabbos Goy. And they did it, management wrote this. So I knew I came to the right place. About 2 weeks after I'm in the show, I'm getting a phone call from Cameron McIntosh. He said to me, Dudu, tell me, do you know the Queen of England? I said, Queen of England? You mean the Queen? He said, yes, the Queen. I said, well, I don't remember going to school with her. She's much older than me. He said, no, I'm serious. I said, what happened? He said, well, we got this phone call from Buckingham Palace, and they're having a dinner of some kind of a show, for charity show, and they asked for you to come and sing a song from Les Mis. I said, that's nice. So there is this one song in Les Mis, which I sang for Ophir, who was just here when he was in the army. He was serving in the submarines in Israel, in the Navy. And my other kid,
who also served in a very, very dangerous unit, Cherry Unit, they call them. I always used to sing this song for them and for their friends. And tonight, today we are in America, of course, I'd like to dedicate this song also, not only to the Israeli soldiers, but all those brave American soldiers who are fighting around the world to bring some peace and stability to this crazy world we live in. Give them a big hand, they deserve it. So let's all pray for them. Please, God, bring them back home safely.
I might have known if God had granted me a son. The summers die one by one, how soon they fly on and on. And I am mourn and will be gone. Bring only a boy. You can take, you can get. Let him be, let him live. If I
very much. You know why they call Jerusalem the city of gold? It's because when you sit around the city in sunset, all the roofs of the city are paved with the color of gold.
Avir harim tzalul kayahim vereach oranim Nisa beruach arbaim im kol pa'amonim Uvetardemat ilan va'even Shvuya b'chaloma Ha'ir asher badad yoshevet Uveliba choma Yerushalayim ושל נחושת ושל אור, הלא לכל שירייך
אני כינו ירושלים של זהב ושל נחושת ושל אור הלא לכל שירייך אני כינו The wells are filled again with water The square with joyous crowd On Temple Mount within the city The shofar sounds out loud And in the caverns in the mountains A thousand suns will grow We'll take the Dead Sea Road together Which runs through Jericho Yerushalayim, all of gold Yerushalayim, bronze and light Within my heart I shall treasure Your song and sight Yerushalayim, all of gold Yerushalayim, bronze and light Within my heart I shall treasure Your song inside Ach bevoi hayom lashir lach velach likshor ktahim katonti mitzeir banayich umeachon hamshorerim kishmech tzorevet hasfatayim כנשיקת שרה אם אשכחך ירושלים אשר כולה זהב ירושה ושל נחושת ושל אור הלא לכל שירייך אני כינו ירושה נחושת ושל אור הלא לכל שירייך אני כינו
The song was written by Naomi Shemer. Naomi Shemer is the national, the Israeli biggest. And she wrote so many songs. I'd like to sing for you two more songs, which became like hymns in Israel. They say that they stole the songs from the Beatles.
עוד יש מקום רחוק באופק מול ענן שחור כבד כל שנבקש לו יהי ואם בחלונות הערב אור אחד נרד יועד כל שנבקש לו יהי לו יהי לו יהי ענה לו יהי כל שנבקש לו יהי Let it be, let it be, Anna Let it be, כל שנבקש לו יהי מה כל ענות אני שומע כל שופר וכל תופים כל שנבקש לו יהי שמע בתוך כל אלה גם תפילה אחת מפי כל שנבקש לו יהי Let it be Let it be אנא let it be כל שנבקש Let it be Let it be Let it Let it be אנא let it be כל שנבקש לו יהי. על הדבש ועל העוקץ, על המר והמתוק, על ביתנו התינוקת, שמורי לי הטוב. על האש המבוערת, על המים הזקים, על האיש השב הביתה מן המרחקים. על כל אלה, על כל אלה, שמור לי אלי הטוב. על הדבש ועל העוקץ, על המר והמתוק, השיבני והשובה אל הארץ הטובה. מרשרש אילן ברוח, מרחוק נושר כוכב, משאלות ליבי בחושך נרשמות עכשיו. אנא שמור לי על כל אלה ועל אהובי נפשי, על השקט, על הבכי ועל זה השיר. על כל אלה, על כל אלה, שמור נא לי אלי הדבש ועל העוקץ, על המר והמתוק. לא על נטה הכל נטוע, אל תשכח את התקווה, השיבני והשובה אל הארץ.
On the piano, my best friend, maestro, the one and only, Shai Bachar. Thank you very much. I don't know, what's the time? What is it? 4:30. You know, I love to walk on beaches. And I walked on all of them, really, like from Vancouver to Rio de Janeiro to Sydney. Rio de Janeiro, Sydney. But the beach I love to walk most is Netanya. And that's where I live. I'm telling you guys, I thought all my life that I'm going to spend the rest of my life, I mean the third of my life, I thought the last third of my life, I thought I'm going to spend it in Miami. I loved Miami, really, I still like it a lot, you know, I'm working there a lot. But when I came to Netanya, I found that it's even better than Miami. It's so beautiful there. And I remember when I used to walk the beaches of Tel Aviv, I couldn't help but think, you know, that only 75 years ago, only 75 years ago, little boats came out from the stormy seas of the Mediterranean, carrying people with big dreams to build a safe haven for the people of Israel. Od Avinu Chai, Od Avinu Chai, Od Avinu, Od Avinu, Od Avinu Chai. Come on. Am Yisrael, Am Yisrael, Am Yisrael Chai. 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 This land is mine. God gave this land to me. This brave and ancient land to me. And when the morning sun reveals her hills and plains, then I see a land where children can run free. Sing with me now, Od Avinu Chai. Vavienu Letzion Yircha, Letzion Yircha Berina, Vel Yerushalayim Beit Mikdashecha Besimcha. Vesham nase lefanecha et kovenot chovoteinu temidi kesidra umusafim kehi. Od Avinu Chai, come on, I want to hear. Od Avinu Chai. One more time, V. Od Avinu. So take my hand and walk this land with me. Walk this ancient land with me, for I am just a man, becoming by my side. With the help of God, I know I can be strong to make this land our home. If I must fight, I'll fight to make this land our own until I die. This land is mine. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Are you sure you have time for another song? This song is a very American song, very American. But I'd like to sing for you the translation into Hebrew. And I think that this is very appropriate at this time, because the world is going so crazy. Israel is crazy. But I'm sure that everything is going to be okay at the end of the day. You'll sing the words that you know, okay? And I'll sing in Hebrew.
כשאני רואה בחלוני את שמוריק לך וגם לי, אז אני שר לעצמי. השמיים כחולים, ענן הוא לבן, והבוקר בהיר, ובלילה ישן, ואחלום לעצמי. בכל עצי הגשם עושים ואהובים פרוסים על פני הגשם על פני האנשים, והיום כה יפה וקל לי כל כך לומר שאני אוהב אותך. והנה ילדים בוכים במיטה, מה שהם ילמדו לעולם לא ידע, אז אני שר לעצמי. What a wonderful world. בכל אנשי הגשם פוסים בחדשים, פוסים אחרי הגשם על פני האנשים, והבוקר בהיר וקל לי כל כך לומר שאני אוהב אותך. השמיים כחולים, ענן הוא לבן, והבוקר בהיר ובלילה ישן, וחלום לעצמי. What a wonderful world. And I said to myself, what a wonderful world.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Happy Father's Day, everybody. Thank you. Shai Bachar. Gabriel, thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you.